Why on earth do you need plug-in, Doctor? You should use your ears and not judge with some graphs. I used to be in that camp as well, and I still, for the most part, think that. But I have come to appreciate plug-in Doctor more. It's perfect to show frequency, harmonics and saturation behavior, which I have found to be very useful in the videos I do. Now DDMF has released Plugin Doctor 2, which comes with a plugin version to use in your DAW instead of just standalone. So this means you can now run Plugin Doctor inside of Plugin Doctor if you're a masochist. A new function which makes absolute sense in a DAW is that the Plugin Doctor plugin will now put through the audio of the plugin. So any change you make will display and also be audible, which is a big advantage over the standalone version. You can still load in two plugins for comparing, and with this toggle you can very quickly A/B between the audio of two plugins, which makes A/Bing between two plugins a breeze. So if you have two plugins which have a slightly different sound, you can easily make sure they have similar curves and EQ boost and decide which one you prefer. Let me show you when I tell about the splits function inside of DistroKid. This is a function in DistroKid to save you a lot of hassle when you need to split the 3 cents of revenue you get off your Spotify streams. Just enter the percentage you want to split, and you can even start with a one-time recoupment and percentage after that, which is great when you have, for instance, hired musicians for your song. There's a resizing bug, as you can see in Windows. And I experienced a huge load of 60% GPU, which was gone when I closed the Plugin Doctor window. With a plugin which allows to load in other plugins, you most likely run into quirks and issues. And there are some with the Plugin Doctor plugin. Some plugins don't work properly in the Plugin Doctor plugin. For instance, with Goldfoss and also Acoustica plugins, I usually get no audio throughput when I select it, and I even had white noise on an occasion. Also, you might find a setting in a plugin inside Plugin Doctor and not want Plugin Doctor opened at all times. You cannot drag and drop a plugin inside Plugin Doctor or drag one out. Saving a preset is the answer in this case, and many plugins offer that option. But for instance, Plugin Alliance plugins don't have a native way to store plugins. They rely on what the DAW offers. So that would mean manually duplicating settings from within Plugin Doctor to an inserted plugin in your DAW. The Plugin Doctor plugin feels a little bit unreliable to me right now. I might probably use it at times, but for now I will stick with the standalone version. The issues I encountered will probably be ironed out in future versions. Plugin Doctor can really be abused to draw all the wrong conclusions of a plugin. But it can help to objectively get a comparison between two plugins and painfully show how similar some are. Like the Plugin Alliance AMAC 250 and AMAC 200, for which I used Plugin Doctor to let them sound exactly the same. You want to see that video.